And now to our commitment 2010 election coverage with the Pennsylvania primary just 15 days away. The race for one of Pennsylvania's U.S. Senate seats is heating up.
Democratic incumbent Arlen Specter and his challenger, Congressman Joe Sestak, we just saw the ads, bitterly attacked each other during a televised debate this weekend.
8 on Your Side government reporter Matt Belanger is here with one of our favorites. The Truth Check Report.
That's right. We have ad watch for the political ads, and
like
we have truth
meters.
Checks. Yeah. That's okay. Right. And these are designed to check the facts of the claims candidates are making in speeches and, of course,
debates.
During debates. That's right. And that's exactly what we did with this weekend's debate, where Sestak and Specter each tried to win over fellow members of the Democratic Party. As Arlen Specter went head-to-head with Joe Sestak in Philadelphia, Sestak accused the longtime senator of allowing a political bribe to influence how he voted.
Rick Santorum said that in order to get his endorsement, you agreed to give the next two votes to whomever George Bush nominated Supreme Court, on the record.
That's true. Former Pennsylvania Senator Rick Santorum did say that before a group of Republicans last month in Louisiana. Santorum is recorded in the Washington Post as saying, quote, I got a commitment from Arlen Specter that no matter who George W. Bush would nominate, he would support that nominee, end quote. But we may never know for sure if there was any kind of a political deal in play because it's one politician's word over another. Specter denies there was any agreement. In the next claim, Specter responds to Sestak's attack of his record with a jab of his own.
He was registered independent until the spring of 2006 when he decided to run for Congress.
We say that's true as well. In fact, Sestak said it was the case moments later in the debate and also provided viewers with an explanation.
I was registered independent for 31 years in the United States military because I believe, just as Colin Powell and Wesley Clark did as registered independents, that the military should be non-political.
And we'll continue our truth check coming up in just a few minutes tonight on News 8 at 6. We'll highlight the most contentious moment of the debate, and we'll check the facts behind everything from Specter's voting record to Joe Sestak's military service.
I love that because it's really hard to know who's telling the truth, so thank you very
much. That's why we're here.
Yeah, it's great.
Truth monitor for us, Matt. Thank you.